excellence of execution. What a matchup this is going to be.
Spine tingling.
Take Boxcar's place?
What do you mean? I can't play the guitar.
Well, neither can he. I got news for you.
Well, I can't sing.
Well, neither can they. You'd fit right in.
Well, I can sing. I know a lot of ladies like the way I serenade them. I guess I could if I wanted to adapt, put my mind to it, play an instrument, but I don't care to do that. This man is talent. He can sing. He can dance. Former Intercontinental Champion. One half for Rhythm and Blues. That's the Honky Tonk Man. Great, great singer and dancer.
What's that guitar? He plays that guitar. What do you think, I was born yesterday? Give me a break, Wayne. $1 Million Team really looking forward to the Thanksgiving tradition, Survivor Series. The captain, of course, Ted DiBiase, the $1 Million Man. Rhythm and Blues, along with a surprise team member, Dylan. What do you know about that?
I don't know a thing about it. I've asked him personally. I've called him off on the side. I've gone up to his room in the hotels.
Maybe that surprise member is in that big egg.
I don't know. Oh. I asked him.
Because I heard there was something definitely alive inside that egg that's going to hatch.
Well, I guess someone's heard things in their move, or I don't know what's, if there's more than one thing in there, or a bunch of things. But I asked Mr. DiBiase, I said, Teddy, level with me. Who's your mixture partner? He said, Bobby, I can't even tell you. I said, well, that's the way you want it.
I want somebody else.
And then he gave me some dash and I left.
Oh, yeah. Opposition for the $1 Million Team, of course, the Dream Team, captained by the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Hart Foundation, the Hitman and the Anvil, along with Coco Beware and Frankie.
You know, he'll give you money if you talk to him.
I'm sure.
I've made a lot just talking.
Yeah, I know.
I'll introduce you to him.
You and that other piece of garbage, brother lover, so deep into this guy. You got his hand right in his, your hand.
He
right
is, he's a generous man.
Yeah, he's a mark for you.
Come on, watch him now.
I'm telling
him. Go ahead, be my guest.
He won't like this. I'll introduce you to him if
he's
you want.
He's got your price, and it's not very much. I know that.
Hey, you can pick up a sawbuck if you go with
me. Yeah, sawbuck.
I'll tell you, you give me 25% of what I get from you from him, we'll work a little deal here.
Get lost.
I'll introduce you to DiBiase, you give me $50.
Get lost.
Okay. Well, you're making a bad move here.
I would assume that stooge Virgil will be at ringside as well.
His man's man, his gentleman's gentleman, his bodyguard,
and
Virgil.
And the Colonel will be down there, and you'll probably be around.
I'll be there.
Lurking in the shadows. All those cheap shots you took at the Big Boss Man.
You have to pay heavy, Brian. I apologize to his mother. I did not apologize to him. He made me do what I did out there.
He made you.
Yes, yeah. You don't.
Devil made me do it, right?
No, you don't know what he said about Mr. Perfect and Barbarian.
Who cares what he said?
Well, I do. That's what made me. That's what got me upset.
All those things they're saying about Haku and Barbarian are true.
They are
I
not.
I can prove it too.
No. Don't show those pictures.
I can prove it.
No.
They ought to be worth some money.
No, don't. I don't know how you got a hold
beautiful
of those.
Honky, that's it, baby. You need to eat some grits, Hitman Hart, baby.
What a matchup that's going to be.
Amazing thing is Jimmy Hart at one time managed both of these.
He certainly did.
With Neidhart and Greg the Hammer.
When they were the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
And then they are again.
And then they turned their back on the Colonel. Turned their back.
That's what Colonel
told. Threw the little pipsqueak out where he belonged. Right on his ear.
No, the run. I mean, yeah, Colonel told him. No, I didn't say that.
You
no, I didn't. No,
I'm going to tell a car.
Did not. Don't start no trouble between him and I.
The little rook.
I didn't say that.
Oh, the big rook.
No, I didn't say anything like that. I said the colonel. I was clearing my throat.
So far, nobody with an upper hand in this one.
That's a good move, Honky.
He just run underneath with a hammerlock, but Hitman reverses that in a hurry. Takes him down to the canvas.
See, I didn't say run. I was clearing my throat. See? It's not run, it's
Colonel will be extremely busy Thanksgiving night at Survivor Series. All kinds of work cut out for him. He's going to be out there with the Natural Disasters, then he'll be out there with the $1 Million Team.
You know, with me and the Colonel out there, the way I have my brain set on this sport and know what I can do, and the way he can motivate people, and the size of Earthquake, and the power of Bravo, and the determination of Haku and Barbarian. Oh, I missed it. What happened?
Yeah. Colonel stuck his little grubby little meat hook out there trying to trip the hitman.
See, all you people are like, none of you have ever managed and don't understand. Sometimes when a man's coming at you, you may point at him or reach through, and that guy kicks at you. It looks like we're trying to grab him. You wouldn't do that because it's against the rules.
Oh, yeah.
You run, dare and break the rules. No, it's clearing my throat.
A little runt again,
I didn't say run.
I marked that down.
What do you say?
It's clearing my throat. I didn't try to start any trouble between me and the colonel. Now you got me calling him a runt. I didn't say that.
Pipsqueak was bad enough, but runt is so descriptive. Right hand.
Wow.
By Honky.
Right in the eyes. Look, he takes his time, points right.
Where are the Honkettes? Are they going to be at the Survivor Series, Brandon? You know?
One Honkette is wounded, and the other two haven't made bail for you. I don't know where the Honkettes are.
What do you give me that kind of an answer for?
Because you'll invent one anyway and make things up. The Honkettes will be there.
Wouldn't surprise me if they couldn't make bail.
They'll be there at Survivor Series.
Headbutt by the Hitman.
If not, in,
roundhouse right.
If not in the ring, he'll be at the party later.
You haven't had a successful one yet, have you? Well, yeah, you did. Yeah, you did. You did with Mr. Perfect.
I have a good friend of mine up there in Hartford.
Who's that?
The Mangy Coyote.
Mangy Coyote. That the dancing Mangy Coyote? Oh, Hitman caught a thumb right in the eye. Here,
Jimmy Hart just gets carried away. He's that kind of a motivating force. I'll have to watch him careful. Very careful.
A testament to the strength, the intestinal fortitude of the Hitman. We've seen him take all kinds of punishment here, both in and outside the ring.
And he's still in there. Well, he's a competitor, there's no doubt about that.
Look out. Tommy Fall, yes! Capacity crowd here in the heartland of America, Indianapolis, Indiana, for the Survivor Series showdown is seeing some tremendous matches, Brain.
Wouldn't you say Beverly Hills is more of the heartland of America than this?
Beverly Hills? How could Beverly Hills be the heartland of America?
Well, everybody's heart is there. They want to live there. Nobody wants to live in this farm community.
Please.
I mean, if you own a plow and your name's...
You know how high on the list Indianapolis is for desired places to raise a family? Very high. You know where Beverly Hills is? In the cellar.
Well, that's because most people can't afford it.
Town in Bethlehem.
Oh, who lived there?
I don't know.
You have to wear a beard and be 4'8" in Argyle socks if you want to live there.
Here goes Chinlock now by the Honky Tonk Man.
A normal guy wouldn't live there. You can live there if you live under a bridge or a rock. But who would want to live here? I mean, unless you have a plow or a tractor. Do you know how to get 11 Kentuckians in a Volkswagen? Tell him you're going to Indianapolis.
You're tougher than he is. You're better than he is.
The Colonel screaming out words of encouragement. And an elbow by the Hitman. And another one. That'll turn him loose. Look out. Shoulder block. Ran over him like a freight train.
Hit him with that knee. Got him.
Right in the lower abdomen again. And the Hitman's in trouble once more.
You're dealing with the...
But I think Honky's running out of gas.
Honky's needle's on E. I mean F.
Yeah, E for empty.
No, exuberant.
E doesn't mean enough, you know.
E means exuberant.
Yeah, you were right the first time. Empty.
I meant F.
Oh, was that close. What you're seeing right now is just a smidgen of what you'll see at Survivor Series.
See, I never called him run.
If you're smart enough to pick up that telephone and call your local cable company or the cable company you're watching right now.
And don't ask him for Survivor Series. Say, hey, jerk, pump that into my house now and I'll pay if I feel like it. That's how you got to talk to these people. They'll come around. You got to lean on them. Try it, kids. And if it's not your cable system, call them anyway.
Oh,
you want Survivor Series.
Stop.
You can order from... Hey, if you send me a...
Is there no end to this? Oh, I got caught in midair. Honky
warming up.
He's a competitor. But he misses the Colonel.
Like the plague. Honky rammed face first into that top turnbuckle. Snapmare takes him over.
Boy, you see the way he snapped him over?
That's why it's called a snapmare.
Well, I know that. I was just trying to make sure the humanoids out there knew it. It's called a snapmare.
Two count is all he could get. Suplex.
Nice. A lot of people think with a flying mare, it takes damage on your back or your lower torso. It's how you get him over. The way Bret Hart took him over, that's the way to take a man.
Oh, what a backbreaker!
That's the way to...
Look at this.
See?
Now who chased him in there now? Who chased him in this time?
You're right. He's wrong. I'll talk to him about that.
What?
I'll tell him you said that.
Look out! Oh,